Tennessee is the 16th most obese state in the nation, and Mississippi comes in second, and Arkansas at number seven. So it's safe to say obesity is an epidemic right here in the Mid-South.
And it is safe to say it's killing us. So it may sound too good to be true, but if you want to lose the weight and, most important, keep it off, you can make that happen. Wellness coach Almetria Turner did it herself. She joins us this morning with three things we can do, particularly for women. Refresh everybody about your journey. You lost a total of how much?
I lost 177 pounds naturally in 4 years.
That's a large person.
That is
actually.
That's a person.
Yeah,
it is.
It's a whole person.
So is it easier for women to do? Is it more difficult for men to do? What do some of your findings show?
Honestly, it's more difficult for women to do because we're prone to actually hold more fat because of us carrying babies.
Yeah.
So we need the fat as far as on our bodies. So it's just a little bit more difficult for us to lose weight, I guess, quicker than men.
But you have taken it off and kept it off. And so we want three real things that we can do, not just to take it off, but to keep it off. What are they in your opinion?
As far as the three things in which you can do, I call them the three F's: fortitude,
okay,
food, and fitness.
All right, let's start with fortitude. So what all does that involve? What do we, or what do women need to do specifically?
Well, for one is strength and character, strength in mind, because we as women, sometimes we put ourselves on the back burner because we're natural nurturers or whatever, and we don't practice enough self-care or whatever. So it's like self-care is really, really prevalent as far as us needing to do so, as far as, you know, taking care of our children, taking care of our husbands, taking care of, you know, as far as our career or whatever. So as far as us putting ourselves on our daily schedule, you know, is
and making it a priority.
And making it a priority, because when you no longer have your health, that's when you realize how important it is.
And that can affect the entire family.
It does.
Yeah,
really does.
So maybe that's how women can flip that switch. I can be a nurturer by first taking care of the nurturer.
Right, what about number two?
It sounds like the mind, though, plays more into weight loss than maybe we give it credit for, because you have to keep that fortitude there.
You really have to keep the fortitude in the forefront of your mind, for the simple fact that I use two daily affirmations every single day: I am and I will.
Got you.
Okay.
All right, number two, what else do we need to look at?
Food is the quality as well as the quantity.
Okay.
As far as the food in which we're eating. You have to make healthy choices every single day. With women, we are usually the head of our households when it comes to purchasing food, as far as grocery shopping, as far as cooking in our homes.
But a lot of people will say, these days with so much going on, you don't have a lot of time. Sometimes it's easier to take the quick way out, and sometimes that's not always the healthiest choices.
And that's true. So that's when planning really comes into play, as far as no organization. What is on sale, you know, this week as far as at the grocery store? What do I currently have within my pantry and my refrigerator where I can put together a healthy meal? What type of staple items do I have where I can sit there and put together a quick meal, under 30 minutes or less?
So it sounds, again, like it is a daily, maybe momentary decision. Every decision we make, we have to think it through and remember what we want and make the right decision to get there.
Right. It's the difference between health and wellness. Health is a complete state of physical, mental, and social well-being with the absence of disease and infirmity. Wellness is the action as far as how we go about achieving good health.
Okay.
So as far as, you know, with wellness in the workplace, there's a lot of programs that are in place for people to achieve great health, but it's a matter of the action behind in order to get the great health.
Okay, it's going to take small steps.
Yes,
okay,
so we talked about fortitude, we talked about food, and
fitness is the thing. 30 minutes per day, 150 minutes per week. Shelter Farms Park is a great amenity that we have within the city of Memphis. They have free fitness programs there that people did not know, in which we have. They have yoga, they have Pilates, they have boot camps that are all free. They have 400 to 500 acres of land that you can sit there and walk for free. There are community centers, there are parks, there are churches that offer free services, even as far as low as $2 a class.
So does it have to be an intense workout or
intense
form of fitness?
No, you can sit there and do 15 minutes as far as walking, as far as on your work breaks, early in the morning, considering how hot and humid it is. As far as, like you were saying this morning, it was only 63 degrees, so it's the perfect weather for you to get like a 30-minute walk in.
So it takes that fortitude to wake up 30 minutes early. Well, you did it. Thank you for giving us three simple things.
Thank you.
Good to have you back.